An average of 1.4 million Kenyans use Safaricom's Fuliza daily, borrowing at least 446 million shillings. 446 shillings. This translates to about 600 million shillings borrowed daily from the telco. The data was revealed in its full year financial report released earlier today. Faisal Ahmed here with the details.
Fuliza, the product that allows customers to access an unsecured line of credit by overdrawing on M-Pesa to cover short-term cash flow shortfalls, continues to be a favorite to many Safaricom customers. In the year under review, the listed telco disbursed 351.2 billion shillings to customers compared to 244.6 billion shillings disbursed in the previous year, this earning it 4.5 billion shillings from an estimated 1.4 million active users daily on the platform. Mshwari, another lending and savings platform on the other hand, saw its disbursements decline by 27.1% during the period under review, posting 94.5 billion shillings compared to 129.6 billion shillings posted in 2020. With at least 4 million active users borrowing an average of 5,500 shillings daily, the platform earned the telco 2.2 billion shillings in the financial period under review. In terms of repayment, Fuliza achieved a 98% rate of repayment, while Mshwari posted a 57% rate. M-Pesa, the bell of the ball of Safaricom's revenue in the recent past, however, posted a marginal decline, earning it 82.6 billion shillings compared to 84 billion shillings it earned last year. This, according to the CEO Peter Ndegwa, was occasioned by the waiver of transaction fees of below 1,000 shillings granted by the firm as part of the country's COVID-19 stimulus package.
Perhaps the most impactful was facilitating reduced cash handling through a temporary zero rating of all transactions below 1,000. Over 1.7 billion transactions valued at Kenya shilling 4.4 trillion were zero rated during this period.
But it was not all doom and gloom for the telco during the period under review, as the mobile data segment raked in 44.7 billion shillings, an 11.7% growth from the previous year. The telco says that its overall performance was largely affected by the measures it took during the height of the pandemic. As a result, Safaricom's net profit declined by 6.8% to 68.7 billion shillings from 73.6 billion shillings it posted last year, its first decline since March 2011. In spite of facing a turbulent year, the board of Safaricom has recommended the payment of 92 cents final dividend per share for a combined share payout of 36.9 billion shillings. Faisal Ahmed, Citizen TV, Nairobi.